Hello everyone, Ninetales Commander here, and welcome to episode 63 of Pokemon Battle Zone. So, here we go again with a couple more matches in today's video. I'm going to lead off with my Weavile, they are going to lead off with an Entei. What is with the rise of Entei? We've been seeing so many of these lately. I think we've had at least three of them in the past bunch of videos, so that's kind of cool. I mean, Entei is awesome, so yay. Which makes me want to use a Raikou, because I really like Raikou. Raikou's awesome. Though, fun fact, Entei was actually the first legendary Pokemon I ever got, because Pokemon Colosseum was my first game. So unfortunately, I'm going to lose my Weavile to the Sacred Fire after I knock his Choice Band off with Knock Off. I'm now going to go out into my Latios, which of course is going to launch off Psychics, and I'm okay with that because it's doing quite a good chunk of damage to that Whimsicott, and it's going to be a 2-hit KO from Latios, so that's excellent. Whimsicott can be quite a pain with all those moves it can learn, like Sleep Powder, Leech Seed. It's better to get rid of it as soon as you can. He brings in his Salamence, which really does not matter with Intimidate because I'm a special attacker. He's now going to Mega Evolve into Mega Salamence. Man, I know Mega Salamence is cool and all, aside from looking like a croissant, but come on, there's so much more to Salamence than just Mega. I mean, you know, you can still use regular Salamence and it can still be quite good. Plus, it's not even Uber. And oh wow, did he just take that double edge with 3 HP to spare? That is excellent. I mean, it's actually quite fitting that that happens because that basically means the last Pokemon he's got is Entei, and I can just KO that with... Well, I suppose he could KO with the Extreme Speed, because I think Entei gets Extreme Speed. I can't be sure, though, but I think it does. But fortunately, he doesn't seem to have it, so I can just KO it with my Psychic. So, that match actually went quite well, because if it wasn't for the 3 HP with Latios, I probably, well, may not have won that. So, good on you, Latios. Well done. So second match now, I start off with my Jellicent, but I immediately switch out to my Lucario because I'm detecting an incoming dark type attack from the Bisharp, which of course I was correct in predicting. Just wish I had Justified on my Lucario right now. Oh well. So he's going to switch out into his Dragonite. Of course that's a smart move because he's probably predicting my Aura Sphere, which I actually did go for, but I'm still okay with it because if I hit it with Aura Sphere with my Mega Lucario, it means I haven't got to fear the multi-scale from Dragonite, so that's neat I guess. So I go for Aura Sphere, of course it's not going to do much damage, but I do carry the Dragon Pulse. I'm pretty sure this is not going to KO because it is Dragonite, it is actually quite bulky, you know, which ain't bad for a offensive Pokemon. But surprisingly he has the Aerial Ace and now he's going to go for Extreme Speed, but wow! Wow, Lucario. First Latios, now you. That's awesome. You barely hung on with 1 HP, nonetheless. That was really surprising. I'm really happy you took that. Quite unfortunate for my opponent as well. Although it doesn't actually matter, sadly, because Bisharp is going to carry Sucker Punch. Which, looking back on it now, I probably should have predicted, because Sucker Punch is a very common move on Bisharp, so I should have seen that coming, to be perfectly honest. So I bring in my Pyroar now, and he's going to bring out his Gengar. He obviously was predicting maybe, I don't know, maybe Focus Blast. Does it get Focus Blast? I don't think it does, actually. Come to think of it, I'm not sure. Maybe he was expecting a Quick Attack or some sort of normal type move. It's probably that. But I actually ended up going for Dark Pulse on that turn because, well, why else wouldn't I? I mean, sure, I went for Fire Blast originally, but unfortunately that missed. So he's going to go for Focus Blast, and this is not going to go well for me. That's a 1-hit KO because, well, it's Focus Blast. What can I say? So he brings in Jellicent now, and he's going to go for Destiny Bond. Oh, crud. That's not good. That's really bad. I should not have used Hydro Pump. In fact, I didn't even see that coming, to be perfectly honest. That's a shame. That means actually I lose. Since, you know, Destiny Bond. Oh well, that's a shame. But either way, it was a pretty good match. So anyway guys, thanks so much for watching and I will see you for Nintendo 64. Episode 64. Bye.